Hegel's masterpiece book is evidence that boundless, uncontainable potential, the Paul Kalanithi kind, it doesn't have to end with your last breath. Death doesn't have to be the end of your story and your influence. Through his book and through his wife, daughter, family, and friends, Paul's potential has been unleashed to the world for perpetuity. And I, for one, am eternally grateful to have had the chance to touch a small piece of his brilliance.
Lucy, congratulations on the Ripples of Hope Award. I can't think of anybody better to receive it. Paul's memoir and your epilogue were beautiful, rattling, disturbing, heartrending. But above all, I think they really reverberate. I think you've provided proof that the dying are the ones who have the most to tell us about living. So thank you.
As a writer and a cancer surgeon, Paul and Lucy's book was inherently important to me. The part that jumped out early was the big decision to return to full-time work in the operating room. This is how he wanted his life measured, to be seen as a healer and supplier of hope.
When I first read Dr. Kalanithi's book, When Breath Becomes Air, I was so incredibly moved because I think that he spoke to a lot of the intricacies of being a physician, but also from the perspective of being a patient and ultimately of being a deeply thinking human being. So thank you, Lucy, for being here, and I can't wait to meet you.
So sorry we can't be with you. Nobody deserves this amazing award better than you do. Wish I was there to give you a big hug. Love Katie too. You're my hero. Love you, sweetheart.
Lucy, Tom Brokaw here, and I am beyond honored to have just a small role in paying tribute to you and to Paul for your life, your experience. His book, When Breath Becomes Air, is not just an American classic for now, but for all time. It's filled with humanity, with information about what all people should know about going through a very difficult medical experience. And most of all, it's a story of optimism. It's a story of taking on life on your own terms, even though you may have been dealt a bad card occasionally. So I want you to know that as a cancer patient myself, not nearly as dire circumstances as what Paul went through, but nonetheless, multiple myeloma is not curable at this point. It gave me not just real insight into what I'm going through, but it gave me a lift. And so the two of you are new American heroes, and I am pleased in some small way to have a part in this evening for Consano to say, thank God we still have Americans like Paul and Lucy.
Lucy, from the whole family, we want to congratulate you and say we love you so much. We love you, we miss Puppy, and we are so happy to have When Breath Becomes Air as part of Puppy's legacy. And just appreciate everything you've done to put it out into the world.
Yeah, Lucy, thank you so much. Of course, without you, there would be no book. The message that's getting out there is as much yours as it is Paul's. And thank you so much.
We love you.